nobody but me. Nobody but me. I'm gonna shit like a boy. Say fuck nobody but me. Nobody but me. You could be just like me. Say fuck nobody but me.
I am Paul.
I am Donald.
I am Jesse.
And ladies and gentlemen, as promised, we have a special magical guest for you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joe Galvin! You might recognize Joe Galvin from basically every other variant of this show we've ever done for the past 2 years. He is a regular cast member, but he is magical and special. So in terms of magical special guest, I hit two of those 3 points. So technically, no one has enough ground to actually sue me for false advertising.
You can't sue us.
You're fucking welcome! We're gonna get you guys started with a game called Spelling Bee. We like to prove that we know things. And we also like to prove that we are actually making all of this up on the spot, right? So, what we're gonna have you guys do is shout out any fucking word you want. Everybody on stage is gonna spell it, and then everybody on stage is gonna tell you what it means. Let's get any word.
Mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese. I heard mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese.
M-A-C-C.
Apostrophe.
C-H-E-E-S-E.
Mac and cheese. And
cheese
is
very
cheesy
in
a
or mouth.
Mac and cheese.
Let's get another one. Any word.
Phalanges. Phalanges.
Phalanges.
Phalanges.
Are
things
that
medical
doctors
look
for
in fingers
and
toes.
Phalanges!
Yeah. That's better than we've done in a couple of shows! Let's get another one! Any word at all!
Pirates!
Pirates!
Pirates are...
Good job, studio audience. All right, this side of the square
Sex.
What was the thing that wasn't sex?
Mario Kart.
Mario Kart, yeah! What's a time period? What's a period in history? Not medieval times, not the Renaissance.
Not sex.
1950s.
1950s.
I like
that. Okay, 1950s. Spin. These guys, where are they standing right now?
Mars.
Jade?
Mars. Yeah, Mars.
Yes. We're on Mars.
Spin.
Where else would we?
And then where did these two meet?
Club.
At a club, all right. Well, yeah. You met at a club.
Do with that what you will.
Spin. Quick reminder.
Mario Kart.
Spin again.
The 1950s.
Mars. In a club.
Okay, do it.
Dad?
It's weird that I have to make the sound effects for our video game, but...
Fuck you, Bill.
Sting!
Alright, crazy idea. What if we just pay women less?
Sting!
So you just stay on that side of the planet. I'll stay on this side. We won't have to...
But why?
Weird and green.
Sweetie, look, I know this is a lot to take in. Hold my clamps, please.
That's
only my sweat on them, okay?
Screw you, dude!
Whoa!
I'll fuck you up, Bill!
Spin!
Baby cigarettes! In the future!
Spin!
Aliens have rights, too.
I want to recognize them. Really do, but you're...
Recognize.
Gross.
I didn't want you to find out this way.
So is this why maybe you're leaving Mom?
It's one of many reasons.
Daddy, it's okay. This club's really
I'm not,
cool.
First of all,
I thought maybe we could go to the
Now that the cat's out of the bag, you should refer to me as Freaky Daddy. No!
Help!
My name's Fred!
Help!
God, you're choking to death! Spin!
We'll never have a black president!
Y'all, give me a name. Give me any fucking movie name. Whatever. Anything.
Space Crows.
Space what?
Space
Crows.
I like it.
Space Crows. Yeah, all right. So this is a special behind-the-scenes sneak peek at the shooting of the Oscar-winning scene from Space Crows. Actors and director, take it away.
McGonagall! They finally broke into our defense, man!
No, Freaky Daddy, no!
We only call ourselves that in our space boudoir, but anyway, you have to make a decision. Do we nuke the nest? This one's, he's about to, we got some kind of shield. Luckily.
Oh,
the, a other than me eating crow. That's
how one up to me.
Freaky Daddy, we gotta do something.
Get the crow ready. Cause right. We're gonna launch.
All right. Cut.
It was good,
but we're shooting. We're great. You know, and I think I got a couple of things that can fix this.
Okay.
You know, your physical movement is good. It's good. But I really need you to like shake a little bit more. We're using a shaky cam.
Yes.
Like we have a shaky
to even
cam.
Out the shaky cam.
Exactly. I need you to kind of jerk wildly so that when the shaky cam jerks wildly, it looks like you're
standing still.
And everybody else is moving. So it's a new directorial technique.
This is great.
I know you can do this.
Okay.
You did great.
Thank you.
The motion is perfect.
Thank you.
We're trying to hit international markets. And I know you vaguely kind of know a lot of different languages. Like,
yes.
You don't actually know them, I know that.
Right.
But, like, if you could just take a crack at it, like, in as many different languages as you can.
That's great. That's with a lot of accent classes. It's quite
I don't necessarily need the accent, but the languages would be
languages.
Great.
Perfect.
Okay.
Yes, obviously.
Obviously. Hey,
merci.
Yes. We wrote you a really great script, and I don't really understand the cause. So I would like you to like. I like the energy coming in, but you like completely skipped your Shakespearean monologue in the middle there. So like, you know, don't forget it. It's like towards the middle of the scene. So just, you know, camera three right there. Be sure to like really commit. All right.
You got it.
We got Space Crows. Take two, action!
Ah! Door!
Wait, the space crows, they're finally breaking the door!
Tortillas!
Madam Presidente!
Right, it's the English?
Madam Foster, yes. But we need you to make a decision. Do we nuke the nest, or do we...
Aloha!
That darkness doth come.
See, senor!
Madam, we have no other choice. It's time to nuke the nest.
All right, cut. Sorry, guys, that was our bad on the technical stuff. Oh. Hey, man, we tried an experimental thing.
It wasn't you.
It was us on the technical side. We bit off more than we could chew. We're going to do a tried and true thing, though. We have one Steadicam that's going to do one take. It's going to be like... following all around as a tracking shot. I want you to make constant eye contact with the camera as it's like zipping along the set, like ignore what's going on. I just need to focus on the tracking shot. Thanks. We won an Oscar, but the languages were good. I need you to keep hitting those. We're also trying to win the Oscar for Best Original Song.
Okay.
If there's enough tonality to it, they'll just consider it a song.
Perfect. Taking voice lessons. Yeah. Great.
Hey, thanks for remembering the monologue. We got notes from the studio. Nobody likes Shakespeare. Here's the zero people have ever liked him, apparently.
What?
Everybody's been pretending the whole time. I bet if you really look inside yourself, you've been pretending too.
What junk?
We have a rewrite here from the scriptwriters. It's a more modern Quentin Tarantino style monologue. So just like really tough, really gritty. Camera three is right there. Don't forget it. All right, take three. I have a good feeling about this one. And action.
Madam.
Hola! Oh no! Oh no!
We need to make a decision right now.
Nous devons coucher avec moi ce soir!
We need to understand what we're doing.
Oh no! Oh, no. Oh,
darling, you're ready to go!
Boy, it hit me in the face.
What he didn't know was that I
just
had time. Stuck a gun in. Taped it to the back underneath the toilet. With that, I will end him and his times.
Padre!
Well, only one way to do this. A hip hop single.
Oh,
studio. I just need everything you just did, but in reverse. All right, just every exact thing, but in reverse order, just for editing purposes. Okay, last take and action.
The only thing that can cure this, a pop hit song for the crowds.
Padre!
Oh, good lord, I've been hit by the camera.
Little did he know, I snuck it earlier and hit a gun behind the toilet. Blah, blah, blah.
Dahlia.
Son of a shabby boy!
Christmas.
No, you can't. Kevin Spacey produced it.
Oh!
Oh, yeah. I mean, we knew, but
he doesn't produce this show. He doesn't. He has nothing to do with this.
Nothing here.
He did fund the commercial you just saw. Sorry. I'm really sorry.
I'm gonna put on my nerd
but he did. We're gonna post a 5-page Facebook status about how bad we feel in a month. The next game we're gonna play, guys, is a game for all of you. We like to entertain you, but we do like to teach you things in the meantime. So we have assembled a panel of 3 experts on anything and everything you could possibly imagine. Now, Jesse is a really good person and really does, like, have a lot of motivation to do well in life. She has a lot of, like, family support, and she's, you know, like, got good friends and made good choices in life. So she gives really good advice. Joe here tries his best. Paul...
What the mother...
It's not going down the leg.
Okay,
it's like,
we just told him the thing about Kevin Spacey.
For the love of God.
Listen, the thing I'm trying to tell you is that I signed a very specific contract when I agreed to do this show with Voodoo 2 years ago, and that contract continues to this day, and Paul has really good lawyers, so I'm literally legally obligated to have this guy up on stage giving you all advice. Don't listen to him, please. Okay? Let's just all agree that we're not going to listen to what Paul says. Okay, everybody just like... all hands in the middle, not gonna agree to what Paul says. Not gonna agree to what Paul says. Yay! All right. So, if anybody at all has any questions on any subject whatsoever, life, love, happiness, random shit, please, we'd love to take it from you. Anyone?
How do you become a space cowboy?
How do you become a space cowboy? That's a great question.
Well, you know, I think there's a space cowboy school. It might be in Florida, I'm not sure. Thank you.
Well, like, when I was young, my dad told me that I should, like, follow my dreams. Like, I don't want to be a space cowboy, but I guess I could be if you wanted me to. I think all I do is, you know, go get a costume, and I put it on, and it has a cowboy hat and a spaceman suit. And I say I'm a space cowboy, and that's how I become a space cowboy.
Okay, good so far.
Fine. Hey, after the show, you get $25. You and Mika go down to Cold Pass and go hit up Z. You got a little bit of that space cowboy for you. I got a nice bridge. We can just chill. We'll just go to space.
So
get a house.
So, different understandings of the vernacular. Yeah. Cool. Anybody else? Anyone at all? Questions?
I think I'm going to get fired. What can I do?
What can you do to not get fired? How can you not get fired from your job? Jesse?
Well, you know, maybe you should speak to the person that's going to fire you and maybe, you know, give them some references or, like, have your mom come in. Thank you.
You should wear a bathing suit and carry a bucket of water. Or a fire extinguisher. You won't get fired.
Thank you.
Paul? No, man, nobody fires a professional hitman, is all I'm saying. Some wet work, like, nobody's taking you out of that business.
You stay wet.
Out of that business. You know what I mean? Like, so you can kill people. Job security.
Anybody else? Anyone? Yes, you.
The girl I like has a boyfriend.
Oh.
Alright, there's... the girl this guy likes has a boyfriend. What do you do?
First of all, I want to say I'm sorry. Second of all, I think they have a thing called Tinder. Just go there and I think someone said once the best way to get over someone is to get under someone else.
There's plenty of girls with boyfriends on Tinder.
There also might be single ladies here, I don't know. Thank you.
So when my mom left my dad, he said that every relationship ends except for the one that doesn't. So statistically speaking, that relationship that she's in isn't gonna be the one that sticks. So you just stick around and like hang out and be friends forever and ever until he leaves, and then you make a move, and then she'll leave you later, and then it'll continue up kind of with time.
Is this helping at all? Paul?
Yeah, make her jealous. All right, by sleeping with a boyfriend. It's really easy. Wow. I mean, just power.
He's not even supposed to be.
I think I gave the best advice out of the group for just being
on. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, the experts have time for one more question.
My crush slept with my boyfriend.
Ooh.
What do I do?
You're okay. So you had a crush.
Yes!
So you had a crush on someone, and that guy slept with your boyfriend.
Yes!
I mean now, hang on. I don't want to gender discriminate. Was your crush a guy or a girl?
A guy.
Okay, cool. So her crush, who was a dude, slept with her boyfriend.
That was very open-minded.
I mean, hey, I think a theme of the past like three shows we've done is that gender is a spectrum and sexuality.
Everybody, let's just please get along. Get along. Is it my turn to talk?
Yeah, no, I thought you were starting.
Oh, okay, I guess I am. Okay, well, maybe you should sleep with their crush. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, I mean, it's at best just a 2-liter bottle that he slept with. So, like, what's the big deal? It's a great beverage, but who cares? If your boyfriend slept with your bottle of crush.
Yo, I'm just throwing this out there for a number of scenarios since this is my last thing. The conditions of the original Saw film are not that difficult.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for we're not gonna do what Paul said. So
we all agree on that already.
The next game we're gonna play. This is for Donald and Jesse. This is a game called Gibberish on Gibberish Off. So they're gonna do a scene, and at various points I'm gonna take away their ability to speak English. And fun things are gonna happen. What's any activity people can do together?
Other than sex.
Everyone was trying so hard to do anything that wasn't sex. Delivering kittens.
Oh, all right. Kittens.
I don't know if you're like delivering kittens from a pregnant cat or if you're like delivering kittens as a service. But I think that that's for you to figure out. Good job, studio audience. Do it!
Sweetheart, did Maisie breed?
Maisie breed it 10 times!
Gibberish on!
Oh, she went. Gibberish
on!
That's not right, sweetheart. They're not supposed to have thorns. This is not good.
Daddy, Bear Daddy was a porcupine.
Sweetie.
It was okay, Mom said go play outside, and I brought the cat, and there was...
we not talked about you playing God in the garage? This is not.
Blah blah blah. Maybe it's an envelope! Is that rhinoceros? Sweetheart, we can't have rhinoceros.
On!
Me, blip, blip, blob!
On!
Mom said all creatures are beautiful.
Mom said a lot of things before she was
blah, blip, blee.
On!
By a mounting blob!
Off!
Let's just focus on the animals! Not you and Mom, you always make it about you and her. It's you and her.
Sweetheart, the only thing
focus
I have...
Focus on me! And my porky kitties.
You know that I want to nurture your creative side, but don't put it on your face.
You're complimenting things. I can't believe them.
The hospital bills? Piling up!
But Daddy, they're so sweet and
Is that baby talk or?
Daddy, I'm old enough to speak English.
But you're not old enough to understand where
I am dribbling blobs.
Bing blobs?
Bing
the house!
But Daddy, this is me learning.
On! Off!
Dad, please just hold on.
On! I'm saying, come.
Off!
All right. Do it.
Daddy, I'm just learning.
On!
Ring ding. Yeah!
Give it up for Porky Kitties. I want one, but I don't. They're so cute and somehow kind not. Next game we're gonna play. We've sold you a movie. Now we're gonna sell you products. We're working on sponsors. So we're working on trying to get sponsors for the show, right? Just anybody who maybe would give us money for any reason. Just any fucking thing at all that we could get money from. A product? A company? A service? Like two people that you met on Colfax? Anybody. Can you, any fucking thing you think might give us money, might sponsor this show, just shout it out. What's the
Snickers.
Product?
Snickers?
Snickers. Snickers, oh, that'd be good. Yeah, all right. So, guys, this is our Snickers infomercial, right? Snickers infomercial. Let's see.
Hey, everybody, are you always hungry? Of course you are. You're like me and you're large. You're probably thinking to yourself, a Snickers bar, look at this tiny thing. It's like a freaking little tiny thing. What you need is a Brickers. It's a Snickers, but it's the size of a standard industrial brick. It's filled with nougat and enough peanuts to choke several children. But I didn't invent it. I'm not smart. I'm like you, I'm dumb. So I have the inventor of the Brickers, chocolatier, Charlie Von Wonka.
Aloha.
Charlie, thanks for coming on my infomercial.
That's no problem, sir.
What inspired you to create the Brickers?
Well, I kept getting locked out of my apartment, and Snickers is my favorite candy. And I used to use this old brick that was laying around the trailer park to break open my door lock so I could get into my home. But now I can just knock it all out in one go.
One thing leads to another. As a child, my family couldn't afford chocolate, so I licked a brick and pretended it was a candy bar.
I was a rich child, but then my family disowned me, and now I live in a trailer park.
You're living the dream, Charlie. Anyway, you got a testimonial from a Brickers lover. This is Deborah. Hi, Deborah. You've been
backstage with the Brickers for the last 45 minutes. How'd it go?
Brickers are so great. They just like open up your chakras.
Oh, you're one of those.
Yes. Wow, that was very... I'm not even going to let that...
I'm just saying it's a practical thing. You can use it as a doorstop. We don't need your hippie
thing. You know, I was going to come in here and compliment you, but now this aura is just not...
Anyway, Brickers is sponsored by both Eastern and Western methodologies. Buy an entire pallet today.
The producers rejected it because you called the audience dumb and the guests fought on the infomercial. Right?
Can we get another?
Yeah, we're going to try another one. Can we get another sponsor? Anybody?
Necklaces?
Just necklaces in general. Yeah, necklaces.
Chains.
Okay, cool. So this is our sponsor, just necklaces. Take it away.
Hey there! Have I got a product for you?
It hasn't been in my jacket all show. Are you looking for something to spice up your jewelry collection? Are you looking for something that you can wear on the town and people are like, wow, I've never seen that before? We don't got that, we got necklaces. This guy, I don't think he actually invented necklaces. They've been around forever. Gave me the necklaces. Tell who you are.
Yo, guys.
Tell who you are.
Yo, my name is Nick.
Tell them about your Walmart style necklaces.
Yeah, I just want something affordable, you know, something you can run your this area, my name. You know, maybe a couple chains. I know there's this kid Connor, he likes to wear a couple.
You gonna be hanging about the train station later?
Yeah, I just thought I would, you know, go right. For the younger.
I might buy more necklaces.
Yeah, bye. Yeah, you can, man.
I like your
finger.
Don't talk about it. The guy that I gave several necklaces to, and he gave me $15, so that's economics.
Yo.
I like the tight ones, because they restrict my breathing.
Yo, man, that's dark.
Yeah, when my brain cells die, it releases oxytocin and endorphins, and I feel love and pleasure.
Can I give you your $15 back?
No, they're mine!
Bro, my name's Nick. What's up?
Hey, Nick. I like your necklaces.
Hey,
so come down near the train station today and get these just plain ass necklaces.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we're with the crew. Marshard! Two takes, and we got a fully approved by the damn network commercial going on.
There's
good news.
Always.
Something else was approved by the network. We, you know, Paul directed that movie. That was kind of an independent film. We flew out to Hollywood for a little bit. We filmed the movie. Matt Damon was in it. It's a great movie. Matt Damon's in it, but that aside, it's a great movie. Great actors. Featuring pretty much everybody in the cast. We got Paul. We got Joe. Half the cast. Everybody in the cast.
Wait, so
and then, of course,
we're not in this.
Then, of course, we have Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
Ladies and gentlemen, Matt Damon.
Famous Matt Damon.
So
applesauce.
Yeah, applesauce.
These guys are doing a scene
from the
summer's hottest action movie.
The summer's hottest action movie.
What is it called?
It's
Sweaty pits.
Matt Damon always repeats everybody else's lines.
So you know how Matt Damon always repeats everybody else's lines, right?
He repeats everybody else's original lines.
So Matt Damon repeats everyone else's lines.
Says
no original lines.
No original lines.
And guess what? He wasn't any better than that in this movie.
Wasn't any better.
Jesus Christ. All right, Joe and Paul, you guys just do the best you can. The suggestion was Sweaty Pits. This is a scene from Sweaty Pits.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sweaty Pits.
Is the skirt supposed to affect sweat?
Is it supposed to affect sweat?
Guys, I think we're missing the larger picture here.
We're missing the larger picture here.
Go on.
We're just not attractive.
We're not attractive.
Well,
nobody's gonna go to prom with us. It's not our stench, it's everything.
It's everything. It's not our stench.
John, that's why I got this makeup kit. With antiperspirant deodorant.
Antiperspirant deodorant.
Oh my gosh! Billy, aren't you supposed to be the makeup master?
I'm the makeup master.
Well then let's get to it, bud. Do us up so that women will ask us out for prom.
It's not our fault. I'm the makeup master.
I don't want to go home alone.
No, it's not our fault.
That would be the future.
Aw, man. Am I attractive?
I'm the makeup master.
Are we attracted yet? Am I looking attractive?
Your eyes sparkle.
Your eyes.
It's not enough, guys. I feel like I'm never gonna be anything.
I'm never gonna be anything either. I'm the makeup master.
Why does it look like this, Billy?
It's not our fault.
I don't know, guys. I think I'm just gonna stay in this prom.
No.
Yeah.
Prom. Prom? Yeah.
Yeah.
We could just.
No?
We dance.
Yeah.
Prom. I'm the makeup master.
Yeah, you can go ahead and make us up, and we'll just go with each other.
It's not our fault.
No, it's not our fault.
Stag party.
No.
Give it up for three dudes going to prom together. Raise your glass to that, because everyone's been there once. Don't fucking pretend you haven't. Next game we're gonna play!
After raising a drink to going to prom alone and there's a weird silence in the middle.
Next game we're gonna play
is
called Dating Game.
Oh!
Yeah. I'll be the bachelorette.
Get out of here.
That's gender normative.
Well, I just wanted to get a drink, but hey.
She volunteered, Paul.
I'm sorry.
So, we've set Jesse up. As a contestant on Denver, Colorado's number one dating game show, I Don't Want to Be Alone Anymore. And we've gathered her three lovely eligible bachelors, or bachelorettes, because gender's a spectrum, and the...
Fuck you, Connor.
I'm
fuck yourself.
I'm just promoting what the scene is going for right now.
Let's not do this now.
Alright, anyway, so these guys are contestants on a shitty 80s dating game show, and because they're on an 80s dating game show, they can't, like, meet women in real life, right?
Like real life.
So just...
What?
So looking at Donald and just gauging him, be nice, not too nice, be a little bit nice, what do you think is wrong with him? If he was a contestant on an 80s dating game show... What would be wrong with him?
Overly
He's not actually
voice.
Single. He's what was that?
Overly nasally voice.
You've just got
That's it.
Okay. I heard overly nasally voice and not actually single.
Okay.
Okay. So you take whichever bits of those you want.
By the way, get ready for that.
Okay. Joe, same question. Look him over. Okay, so I heard bald. Joe, you're wearing a wig and you don't want anyone to know about that.
Definitely not bald.
Definitely not bald. Okay. I feel like you're waiting for it. Paul, look him over. What's wrong with him?
Literally Al Pacino.
Yes! Paul, you're literally Al Pacino. You feel
pretty... I can do this.
All right, so, Donald...
I'm a nasally mark.
And...
I'm not actually single.
There you go. Joe?
I've got a full head of hair. It's very thick. I use a Dawn soap to keep it that way.
Paul. Bigger than! All right.
Great ass.
We're bringing this back in. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to I Don't Want to Be Alone Anymore, Denver, Colorado. Come on, ladies and gentlemen. We got our contestant here, LaRonda McFondo. LaRonda, tell them a little bit about yourself.
Oh, you pronounced my name right.
I mean, it was written down.
Oh, okay, yes. Hi. So, I work with animals.
Thanks, LaRonda! Now, we've assembled three lovely bachelors, bachelorettes. You're gonna figure it out.
Oh, boy.
Behind this curtain that you can't see through.
Of course not.
So, I know you're eager to get to questions.
I'm so eager. It's been a long time.
Take it away.
Okay. Hi. Okay, bachelor number one.
Hi.
What a nice voice.
Thanks.
Can you just...
Excuse me,
I was speaking.
I sense intention already.
Can you tell me what your favorite movie is?
Home Alone. Because when I'm home alone, that's when the party starts.
Wow, I love parties.
I don't like when other people are around and getting in my way.
Sir, thank you. Okay, next person, contestant two, bachelor or bachelorette two.
Hey.
Oh, how friendly. Can you tell me, like, what you and your mother's relationship are like?
Oh, we would spend hours and hours just combing each other's hair. No way would we, complain about my father. We just loved to talk about accoutrements.
Oh. Neat. Contestant number three.
Yeah.
If you're gonna take me out on a date, just like quickly tell me what we would do on our first date. Date number one. So exciting.
Every time I think I get out of the dating scene, drag me back in. We do something adventurous, obviously. Not a bank.
I missed that.
We did not go to the bank. Kate's really on it.
Okay, back to bachelor number one. Now, if you were to be an animal, which animal would you be and why? Because I just, I work at a vet clinic.
I wouldn't be one of those bears that mates for life. It's ridiculous. I would be whatever animal is free to explore. Other conquests, sexual or otherwise. So a dolphin.
Disney movies. What would be your Disney song?
Be our guest. Oh, but also I love when Ariel plays with the Dingle Hopper. I'm torn between
that's
the beast and his hair and so many beautiful songs and so much wonderful hair. Musical hair.
That's so sweet.
That's great.
Can
Tessa
come for you? Hey, you want a lunch? Contestant number three, can you tell me about your financial situation?
It's good. Got a lot of royalties from Jack and Jill.
Are those your children?
No, but it felt like my child. Probably the best mark of my career.
Now, Miranda, we've got exactly enough time for a 1 minute, 60 second long lightning round. As many questions as you can ask these contestants in 1 minute. We've got the timer up. Go!
Contestant number two, would you rather have a brush or a comb?
Oh, a brush. Comb could accidentally to pull the knots out and expose a horrible truth.
Okay, contestant number one, what is your favorite sexual position? Take your time, please, because I have all the time in the world.
Good God, I don't know. It's always been missionary with my what? Or four children.
What?
I live alone. I don't have.
And it's been 60 seconds! Sorry, Al Pacino. I mean, number three.
Oh, that gave something away.
Now, before you guess. I know it's a huge mystery, but do you have any idea who any of the people behind this curtain might be?
Well, I think number three might be Al Pacino.
I'm Tom Hanks!
Al Pacino! And then number two?
I think he is interested in utensils and hair.
No, he has very real hair. Very real hair. Definitely not a wig. Very real hair.
Very real hair.
And
then... He talks a lot when he's married.
He's not single, and we didn't give him talks a lot, but you know what?
He did.
Yeah! Now we gotta know, who are you taking out tonight? Who gets the date?
There's an obvious answer.
I'm gonna go with Paul on this one.
Al Pacino! Yay! Yay! Ladies and gentlemen, this has been the Jester Sport. We are here all of the time. We got lots of shows. JesterSportComedy.com. Find out about all our shit. My name's the Jester. I am also Connor Hall on the streets. Behind me is the cast. Say your names again.
Donald.
Jesse.
Woo! Joseph. Paul, stay for Rapscallions.
Stay for Rapscallions. Yes. Next show, improvised hip-hop freestyle musical.
What?
It is as lit as it sounds.
Me, everybody but me. Looking like this all good, but fuck everybody but me. Everybody but me. And I really wish your nigga would say fuck everybody but me. Everybody but me. And you could be just like me. Say fuck everybody. Everybody but me. Everybody but me. Everybody but me.
Feel it go.
Everybody but me. Say fuck everybody.
KCMO. Born and raised, if you ain't get the memo. I'm slipping in my